I mean, if you want to be tan, just put some bronzer. If you want to be fair, put some powder. I don't think it's the end of the world.
There were many girls who talked about how their tan or their color has made them suffer. So any time do you fantasize about being tanned, or you want to go on beaches and get tanned? Does that color...
I love going on beaches. It has nothing to do with being tanned, but I mean, I love the beach. And I don't necessarily think that... I mean, if you want to be tanned, just put some bronzer. If you want to be fair, put some powder. I don't think it's the end of the world, but I don't think it should define you at all, you know. I think this whole chatter about skin color is like really, you know, I mean, I wanted to put pink nail polish, I put it. If I want to look dark, I'll just spray paint myself. It's fine, you know.
But what about people who are dark and are under enormous pressure to look fair?
This, again, what is pressure? I think that at the end of the day...
Prejudice, rude comments...
I understand that. But
bias, shaadi nahi hogi...
लेकिन आप बदलोगे नहीं मैं बोल सकती हूँ कि सबको बोलना चाहिए कि सब सुंदरता एक ही होती है लेकिन शायद नहीं बोलेंगे यार लेकिन आपको होना चाहिए ना आपके अंदर वो कॉन्फिडेंस होनी चाहिए कि जो बोलना है बोलो
होना चाहिए लेकिन सब में नहीं होता
लेकिन मैं ये मानती हूँ दैट देयर इज अ लार्जर प्रोबेबिलिटी एंड अ हायर सक्सेस रेट फॉर यू टू अटेम्प्ट टू चेंज योरसेल्फ देन टू चेंज द वर्ल्ड बिकॉज दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू चेंज
This burden of celebrity that you carry even before you have a chance to find who you are, establish who you are, carve out your own personality. Not just famous parents, famous grandparents on both sides. How was that growing up?
See, I'll be honest with you. I don't, you know, people have used words like burden, pressure, all of that, but I don't really believe in that. I think that, you know, you're as burdened as you want to be. And you take as much pressure as you want to, you know. Of course, I'm aware, acutely aware, that I come from a film background and therefore the scrutiny or the attention that I have received has been more than it would be otherwise. But I don't necessarily look at that as a burden because if I do, then I will be stiff and I won't be able to perform. And I don't think that that's fun then, you know. Mm-hmm. I think that I'm, like I said, I'm aware of where I come from, but I don't at all look at it as a burden, and I don't think I ever have.
So I think there's a part of it that's a privilege. There's a part of it that's fun.
Of course.
There's part of it that must be mildly suffocating.
I see, again, suffocating is an intense word. I don't know about that, but I think that with any form of kind of, like you said, privilege.
Yeah.
There is a setback to it as well, you know. There is a lot of scrutiny. There are a lot of eyes on us, for instance. And I can't deny the fact that star children, as much as I hate those words, do get it easy, you know. We do have a privilege in terms of access that others don't have. But it also comes with scrutiny. And at the risk of sounding negative, which I don't intend to at all, because whether it's the audiences or the industry or the media, everybody has been very, very loving, maybe even more than I deserve. But I do think that there is a whole lot of people out there who are waiting for you as a star child to make one mistake.
Of course, and to
fall. Or to falter even a little bit to be able to say, dekha, usko to aasani se mil gaya, usme to baat hai hi nahi.
Have you and your brother had equal freedoms?
Again, it's different because I think that I have a progressive mother. And you can't also make the difference between... See, we are not equal. Okay, we should be treated equally politically, but we are not equal.
What do you mean by that?
I can't argue that me and my brother deserve to come home at the same time. We live.
Why not?
Because maybe it's a little more dangerous for me to be
but
out on the street.
Change those.
But
I
can
I? Say a rude word. Change those people outside.
But I can't.
I mean, get them to stay in.
But can I? Or can you?
I would fight for the right of women to stay out as late as men.
I appreciate that, but I also understand and recognize the fact that I as a woman, or my mother as a woman, or my brother as a man, cannot change the intentions of the man on the road.
I know, but it's not because we are not equal, it's because the world is not equal.
Of course, but...
There's a difference, right?
You
see the difference. The world is not equal, we are fighting to make it equal.
I totally agree. But I don't think that it makes it, you know, an example of inequality to allow my brother to come home later than me. I think that these are just few basic things that enable safety. And I think that that's a personal choice and that's okay. But there are bigger things like political rights or access to education or employment or equal pay. And I think in factors like this, equality is more necessary.
So the fact is that you're Sara Ali Khan, new entrant.
Exactly.
But there are the men who are still playing the roles that they played 20 years ago.
Yes, they are.
Like, that has to be slightly bugging.
I mean, yeah, but see, audiences are watching them, you know. So, I mean, you can't just blame them. I mean, audiences are wanting to watch them, like, romance the daughters of the heroines. So then great for them, man. Like, what do you want me to say? Like, I think that it's also, it's a give and take, you know. I think that we as people can turn around and, you know, kind of criticize or question. But look at the people. I think it's also about acceptance. If we women were to put our foot down, maybe we would be treated differently, yeah? Maybe we would. I don't know. Maybe if you said, I'm bored of watching him, maybe he wouldn't be cast for the 97th time. You don't know. I don't know.
But don't you all make, like, jokes about it? Or does it make you angry?
No, I'm a newcomer. All my jokes are private.
Yeah, your answer to everything. You know your get out of jail card is, I'm a newcomer.
Well, no, some people have been regressive. I don't take it seriously. But they say stuff.
Like?
Like, you know... तू तो औरत है तू क्यों बोल रही है ऐसा?
They say this.
Yeah, yeah. And you I've say? I've heard this.
You say I'm a newcomer, yeah. So what do you really say?
You know, honestly, I really feel like I ignore these things because I think the best thing to do when somebody is trying to take away your agency is give yourself multiple agency by ignoring it and being you anyway. It's not about getting into like a banter of नहीं मैं औरत हूँ मैं करूँगी तो करो ना चुपचाप से करो. जब कुछ करना होता है तो नारे लगा के करने की जरूरत नहीं है आप चुपचाप भी कर सकते हो.
We have all these conversations about body positivity now. Does it really work or are women still battling some guy's idea of what beautiful is?
No, I'm sure they are. I'm sure they are. I think that they do. And I think that it's not just guys. I think, I honestly feel that women should be women's best friends. But unfortunately, in the world that we live in, it's really not that way. I think it's the woman that will first say, "Arre, look at her, she's looking so fat. Arre, she's looking so bloated." I don't even think men notice this stuff, you know, a lot of times. So I think it's this whole agenda of like kind of, you know, adhering to this perfect image when I don't even know who came up with it. Like, who decides what's perfect? I mean, if you want to be a little larger than what, you know, the neighbor's wife thinks you should be, then you be that. Just be healthy, because I think that's important. But the rest is your choice and should be always.